Yo, what up, dude? Sorry, I was eating my dinner. All right. Hop down, Teddy. You gotta get off my lap, dude. This is not effective programming position for a pupper. Effective proper programming position. You gotta get your PPP going, dude. Did you just fart on me, Teddy? I think he just farted on me. Are you kidding me, dude? So basically, over the past few days, we integrated Fast Noise 2 with the project, so I can use it in C++ now. And so now I'm back trying to come up with some nice effects here for like our layers, our layers of noise. All right, so we want the continent to control like basic. We're gonna have one layer of really high frequency noise. So we want the continent noise to control like just baseline kind of hilliness. Let's try six. Six octaves. We want some like height variance on the surface of the continents, but not too much. Because in the end, we're gonna. Okay. In the end, we're gonna do something like this. Teddy, calm down, bro. Who's a good boy? Not you. You've been bugging me. You've been bugging me. You've been being a little whiny baby because your mom's gone. And that will get us some. Some like fall off here, or some variance on the end product, right? Who's your That looks pretty good to me. But we don't want to do this yet because this adds a lot of overhead. to the whole operation. And right now we're just working on specific, like, individual layers. Daddy, you can't climb on my computer desk, dude. Hey, buddy. It's not fair. Your mom's not home. That's not fair. That's not fair. That's cheating. You gotta chill out, dude. Here, do you want down? Is that what you're trying to signal? He is so worried. His mom has to work late tonight, and he does not know what to think about that. Hey. She'll be home. She should get home a little later tonight, dude. Can you hop down? Come on. Go on. Go down. Hey. Daddy. Hey. Gotta comfort this worried puppy. Oh my god. Oh my god. It's the end of the world. It's the end of the world. My mom's never coming home. My mom's never coming home. Oh no. Let's put these guys aside for now. This will probably come in at the very end. Let's make a mountain layer. For this, we're going to want to remap. -1 to 1 to 0 to 1. Yep, and then power. That's interesting. Not exactly what I wanted, though. I think I have to scale this. -1 to -1 to one. Then I should be able to run ridge noise. Ooh, that's kind of interesting. Can I just multiply this by like a low number? Okay, that's not how we're gonna be able to do it. Okay, so this has to be scaled to the same scale. As up here. I guess I can't do it like that. Okay, sure. Sure. Domain offset. We'll do a negative one on that as well. We don't need this here yet. Next, now we're gonna need, let's take our purlin noise down here and let's build some mountain peaks with some ridged multifractal. Is fine. Point 0.5 is fine. Okay. Then we're going to need to domain scale this. Now let's try multiplying. Is there a reason I can't? Okay, there. And now if you use your imagination, we got some mountain ridge lines. So the next thing we gotta do is modifier, how about smooth max? Okay, it is in the, it's in the wrong domain. That's why we have output on our zero. The other thing we're going to want to do this looks somewhat mountainous already. Those aren't looking too bad. What if I add one before I do the multiply? What happened then? Well, yeah, that would cause an issue, but before doing the min smooth. Alright, well, let's just get rid of this and instead let's do one more multiply. These look like pretty interesting mountain ranges, so let's go see what happens when we first, let's take a look at what that does to the overall terrain. Let's see it with the ocean mask so that we can kind of see what's going on here. All right, and then in addition to all this, we're gonna want at least one layer of just like All right. So I was getting the smooth line at the center because that's where my zero was. And now I'm getting the smoothness at the bottom because that's where my zero is. This is probably better for our purposes. But I would like to see the non-smooth version. across the mountains. You go on mute for a bit.
You and Duncan, I'm not seeing it.
My fans is Coyle Munchkins.
I don't know if it's enough to be the only person with fans literally named.
Squadron 42. So it's like in space or some shit.
Go for six.
Getting a faint contact on bearing 287. You picking that up?
Yeah, got it. Scanning that.
All right.
We're clear.
Okay, this is nice.
Provided in the sure. Traffic is restricted under lockdown.
Copy that.
This looks good.
Archangel. Archangel, this is Krugeri.
Come back, Krugeri.
Redirect to Sector 7 Bravo Echo for immediate tasking.
Copy that. On our way.
So they're just flying around? It's all in-game footage, by the way. Oh, shit. That's... Damn, alright, that's cool. What the fuck? That was cooler than I expected it to be, honestly. Okay. Big ship is mine, by the way. I bet it is. What's the name again? Squadron 42. And this is apparently, somebody says this is all in-game footage. Just a random guy.
I know I just wrote you. But a couple of hours ago, proximity sensors
on the other
side
of the jump got twigged. Let you know. Deck whenever I could to watch the launches.
This is pretty good, I would say.
Have you seen the F-8s up close?
No, sir.
The thing's a beast. Nimble, too.
12 maneuvering. Thrusters and three mains, it sure sounds like it.
So this is on like Earth or some shit. It says Manchester. You know what they should have right now? They should have like another like a riot in the streets over like a soccer game. Just to show that like even in the future some things do never change.
Welcome to Cloud Imperium Games Manchester Studio. I'm Chris Roberts, and I'm pleased to announce we have just passed the major milestone. Squadron 42 is now feature complete and has entered its polish phase. To celebrate this milestone, we've gathered some of our core leadership together to share...
So that you feel like an actual pilot, whether that's firing your weapons, taking hits, or punching the afterburners to get to cover.
I'm going to be honest. I feel like this looks pretty decent. Yeah, like, this actually looks pretty decent. The FPS is probably not optimized yet, or maybe there's something wrong with it. Like, I mean, obviously you're not going to release the game like this. I mean, maybe they will, but I kind of doubt it.
Seen huge improvements.
The rest of the game with seems pretty clean. Engagement distances, I doubt that they're just going to release a game that's this clean with so many other things where, like, the frame rate is bad, you know?
With the aim now on polish, we've organized the project into self-sufficient strike teams, so we can focus on individual areas to deliver the best.
So even on the ground too. Okay.
Get out of sight. The cops is gonna spot you.
So why are people saying this is Star Citizen?
With a unified vision of enhancing the gameplay by seamlessly blending it with polished visuals.
Because this isn't the name of the game. It is.
Performances and our ever-improving technology.
So. This is a single player version. Okay. All right.
You didn't see the boat, kid. You're good to keep going.
We're also dialing in gameplay features, such as the ship flight model, for both atmosphere and space, which covers master modes, control surfaces, and our gold standard HUD and MFDs.
Yeah, I feel like this looks pretty decent.
Our interaction system for both the world.
I think the gameplay, like the graphics here, look good too. The graphics in a weird way remind me of Armored Core 6. I don't know exactly what it is about it, but there's like a lot of like very clean textures, and like to me it reminds me a lot of that.
And your character have also seen additional improvements, allowing us to hone and craft environmental puzzles unique to each location.
It's the lighting, maybe.
To tell the story of the
world. Yeah, I don't know exactly what it is.
Yeah, so I'm actually gonna bail for a bit. I did.